We have just made it to Marmot Basin, and it is negative 20 degrees Fahrenheit outside. As you can see, I have two hats on, but today is very exciting because it is Claire's first day ever skiing.
Yeah.
Oh, it's going to be a fun day.
Yeah, this is something that we've been wanting to do since like 2021.
Yeah.
Like, it's been long overdue. I'm so excited that we're finally here and want to say a really big thank you to Marmot Basin for hosting us and for giving me this opportunity to go skiing for the very first time ever. It's definitely probably the coldest day we've ever faced in our entire lives. So not only am I learning how to ski today, I get to check off a personal record of dealing with such cold weather.
Yes, but without further ado, we are gonna go towards the lodge. We are here. One thing I will say is that because it's so cold and a lot of the ski lifts are closed, there's not a lot of people here, which is really nice.
Going into this day and this experience of learning how to ski for the first time, I felt a lot of different things, from nervousness to excitement to intimidation to optimism, feelings all across the board. And now that it's actually happening, all I can think about is not failing.
All right, she has now put on her skis. She's about to embark on her first little run.
Ever since I transitioned into adulthood, I've noticed that I've built up this tremendous fear of failing. And I feel like, and I say feel in the present tense because I'm still dealing with this insecurity now, but I feel embarrassed or bad about myself when I don't completely excel or succeed in what I'm doing, even if it's my very first time doing it, which I know sounds so ridiculous. And I've come to realize as I've gotten a little bit older that failing is just a part of life, because without failure, there is no improvement or success.
Woo! Having fun?
Yeah, I'm on the magic carpet.
Are you warm enough?
Yeah.
Okay,
just check. I think I'm moving so much that I feel okay.
How's it going so far? How's your instructor?
Very good. Very talented. I think I'm learning pretty quick because he's so good at explaining it.
You feeling more confident?
Yeah. Like, I don't have my pulse right now. Which I didn't think I would go without the poles. So with today's ski adventure, I'm reminding myself that even if I can't make it all the way down the mountain because I'm just too tired to go on, or if I just end up falling over and over again, I'll know that at the very least, I tried and gave it my best shot. And that really is all that matters at the end of the day. So, you know, if you have ever been nervous or scared of taking the leap to do something you've always wanted to do because you're afraid you might fail, do it anyways. Life is meant for you to go out and try things that are just out of your comfort zone. So just do it and don't look back.
Claire is down. Woo! I'm so happy to be snowboarding again. This is so exciting. I feel like it's muscle memory. Not that I've really done it that much, but the times that I have gone, it's been really fun, but it is freezing here. All right, I've switched the GoPro. My face is completely numb, but I'm so really grateful to be out here. Man, these guys are amazing. Wow. That's gonna be clear pretty soon. All right, first round is complete. I'm back on the ski lift. I'm thinking that this is the perfect time while Claire is in her class for me to just go and go and go. Since this is the only ski lift that's open right now since it's so cold, I'm gonna take full advantage. I can see Claire off on the hill. There she is. Yeah, Claire. Woo! Yeah, Claire! Oh, this is so much fun.
Clipping back into this board and carving down this mountain has reminded me of what it's like to be a kid again, because I was actually lucky enough to grow up going snowboarding every other season, and it was something that I honestly was never that good at because I've sprained both of my wrists while I was a kid doing this. But it's something that I always really enjoyed, just having the fluid motion that your body gets into and that rhythm of going back and forth and trying to find your balance. You don't really think about anything else. And I think as I've started to get older, it's been harder for me to get out of my comfort zone. And being on this board today has really reminded me of how important it is to be uncomfortable, especially with this cold weather.
Yeah, Claire! Woohoo! Yes!
Thank you so much. Yeah. That was amazing.
You did a really good job for your first time.
Thank you. You're a really good teacher.
I try my best.
Yeah. Bye. Thank you.
Right. You too. Enjoy your time here.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye. Claire just finished up her first ski lesson, and it is so cold. Look at her. If I was touching the camera with my hands, and it literally feels like I burned my hand because it's like that cold.
Yeah.
Like it's not, the
it's
back
no
of the
joke
camera.
Out there.
Yeah. Like if you take your gloves off for a second, it just hurts.
Yeah, it does. Like there was this point where I felt just such pain in one of my fingers, and I thought like I got frostbite or something, but then I was like, quickly wake up because I didn't want frostbite.
All right, so we are now back in the car. Claire finished up her lesson, and we're going to reassess our life right now.
We're going to reassess and also reflect on what just happened, because a lot did just happen, and I think our brains just need to thaw for a second before we can talk. Now that my hair is back to its brown color, and I've wiped off the tragic mascara gloves around my eyes, we are ready to recap on all that just happened, and honestly, I do think I did a little bit better than how I thought I would perform, just because I am so scared of falling, and like that whole time, my legs were shaking because I felt like it was gonna come, and I did fall, but only once. and that fall actually took me like several feet down the mountain.
Yeah, it was funny. Instead of falling, Claire decided to like crouch.
I was like, you know what? I'm just gonna sit down. But the problem is the further you crouch, the faster you start going. So there was no end until I basically hit this massive pile of snow.
Yeah, and while Claire was in her lesson, I decided to go on the ski lift one extra time. And during that time, I was getting pretty confident because I'm like, wow, I'm snowboarding. I haven't done this in a while. And I was trying to show off in front of Claire. And that's when I fell and actually hit my tailbone pretty hard. Oh. Ouch. So I am the sore one and Claire is perfectly fine.
And that is why you don't show off. I did realize that I had muscles that I didn't even know I had because I've never worked those muscles before. So that was really interesting. And then something else that I kind of figured out this year, that when animals are met with danger, they either have the fight or flight response, but sometimes they have the freeze response, and that is what I have. So when I'm really, really scared, I just freeze. And I basically won't do anything until something else just hits me. I think that's one of the reasons why I don't even drive, because when I do get scared, I'm just gonna be sitting at the wheel and I don't know what to do. And that was the exact same thing that happened today during my lesson. So I wanted to say a really big thank you to Jacob for being so amazing. And honestly, if you do come up to Marmot Basin, ask for him, because he is a fantastic teacher and he's gonna be working here all the way until May of 2023. Yeah. So if you find yourself in Alberta, ask for him.
So with that being Claire's first lesson, I have to say that I'm very proud of both of us because that cold is a cold that I've never experienced before. Like I walk outside and 10 seconds later, my nose is already like numb.
Yeah.
So that was pretty brutal.
For the rest of the afternoon, we're going to rest up, eat some snacks, and then we're gonna go out for dinner. So we'll pick it back up once we're heading back out.
We have been eating microwave food or junk food. So this is actually our first proper meal in I think like 3 days. And we're very, very hungry after a day out in the snow. So we're gonna dig in. I got an Alberta steak and then Chad got some Alberta bison short ribs. So they both look so good and I can smell the garlic.
Our lodge here in Jasper has these outdoor hot tubs and they're steaming like crazy because it's currently negative 20 degrees Fahrenheit outside, and I think we're gonna do a reverse polar plunge. So basically we run through extremely cold weather and then we jump in a nice steamy puddle of water basically. So all right, we have like a tiny little towel covering us and we're about to run out.
After you, m'lady.
Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh, it's so cold.
Nice.
Okay, now that I'm in, it feels really good.
Wow, this feels good though.
Yeah.
Oh, that's nice.
I love the snow just coating the rim.
Ice. We're like in a giant margarita.
The thing is, like, these seats have you a little too high above the water. We just need to squat awkwardly in the middle.
This isn't too bad.
As you can see, we've been sitting here for a while because pretty much everything that isn't in the water is frozen.
Yes.
But we were talking to a really nice couple from Australia and just relaxing our muscles.
Yes, especially my tailbone after trying to show off. Anytime I try to sit down, I'm like, oh, I feel like an old man.
Yes, wish Chad some nice healing.
Thank you.
But I think we're gonna end the video here. So we will actually be staying in Jasper for just a little bit longer and exploring the national park. So if you like to join us, hit subscribe as we travel to 50 countries around the world. And with that, we'll catch you guys in the next one.
Bye guys.